It's race day here in Italy once again. Monza, home to so many records. The smallest winning margin, for example. Do you remember in 1971, Peter Gethin beat Ronnie Peterson to the line by 1/100th of a second. There were 40 overtakes for the lead alone in 1965, and Kimi Raikkonen clocked a record top speed of 230 miles per hour here, just over a decade ago. So there's a lot to live up to then for all of our drivers today. With top speeds in excess of 220 miles per hour, few places can hope to touch Monza's crown as the fastest circuit in Formula One. Hard braking zones going into three chicanes make up the majority of the 11 corners on this 3.6 mile circuit. And just in case the slipstream wasn't enough, well, two DRS zones will help encourage some close action. It's a very tight turn one here in a very big braking zone. It's a corner, Anthony Davidson, where we've seen a number of lap one incidents in the past.
As you say, it's a very small piece of track when you have more than just one car trying to go through it. The actual run down towards the chicane is quite wide, so at the start, we'll often see drivers running two or maybe three abreast as they come up towards the braking zone. Everyone wants to brake late, of course, to win track position, and that tends to be where we see a lot of contact. You'll see the more experienced drivers kind of hang back a little into here and focus more on picking up the pieces from other people's incidents.
You've done well to put it on pole, but we've still got work to do. Trying to cover the inside line off the start.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. It's McLaren in pole position then, and Kimi Raikkonen completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Vettel, Hamilton, Nico Rosberg, and Ricciardo, Verstappen, Bottas, Sainz, and Nico Hülkenberg, Perez, Kvyat, Jenson Button, and Massa, Grosjean, Wehrlein, Esteban Gutierrez, and Rio Haryanto, Nasser, and Magnussen, Marcus Ericsson, and Jolyon Palmer rounds off the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
patient and watch for the lights. caution zone, be careful until you see the greens. The pit window is open.
Yeah.
look serious. the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. seconds. They're on old softs. You think they've got one more stop? The time last lap was a 1 minute 28.6. some kind of problem with their car. Strategy change available to us. Would you like to keep to the current plan or try the new? approaching the safety car. You're leading, so don't pass it. Stay behind the safety car. position until the green flags.
stuff from McLaren today. What a superb victory. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
Well, the safety car completely changed the race, didn't it? It's hard to say exactly what would have happened without it, but there's no question that they came out of that situation in a good position.
And look at that, they're making their way out onto the podium now. Great race from the McLaren team, and I'm really happy to see them there on the top step of the podium. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. It's a good result for Lewis Hamilton, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
It's got to be Romain Grosjean. He was in another league for me today. Really impressive.
On to the constructors then. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. That's it for today's Grand Prix, and from Ant and I, it's goodbye and see you again next time.